this is Courtney from rulebreakersclub.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create beautiful worksheets, workbooks, and other PDFs for your business. This is something I get asked about all the time, and I want to share with you because I don't have a design background, and I'm assuming you don't either if you're watching this video, yet you probably care about how your worksheets and workbooks look, and I'm going to show you exactly how to do that if you stick around and watch the rest of this video. Now, the software I'm going to teach you how to do this in is Pages for Mac, but before you click away, know that if you have a Macintosh computer, Pages comes pre-installed in Macs these days, and if you don't already have the application, it costs about $20 in the Apple App Store, so just go and grab it. It's such an easy expense, and it's going to help you to create beautiful, beautiful, beautiful worksheets and PDFs for your business. All right, so let me show you how to create a PDF workbook like this using Pages for Mac. So Pages is the application I've been using for the last 7 or more years to create beautiful worksheets and PDFs for my business. I get asked all the time where I create my PDFs, who I have create my PDFs, how I do it, and this is the answer to that question. And first, what we're going to do is we're going to go up in Pages to File, Create a New Document, and we're going to pick a basic blank document like this one. Now, the first thing we need to do is we need to set up our formatting on this document to make it so that we can design it. So it's less of a word processor and more of a design application. In order to do that, you want to go up to Document here, and you're going to go down here where it says Document Body, and you're going to uncheck this box. It's going to say, are you sure you want to convert to a page layout document? And you do, you want to click Convert. So now that we have our new layout, what we want to do is we want to start designing our elements. Now, my number one rule for design, not that I'm a designer, I really know anything, I have no training in design, but my number one rule is always to keep it simple. I like to use color in my design, so I always pick a way to use that color, and I try not to go too crazy with it because I know it can be overwhelming. And you also want to think about if people are going to be printing your document or not, because if they're going to be printing it, you don't want to be using a whole ton of color everywhere. You want to make sure that you're being kind to your people, especially if it's an opt-in offer and you'd really like them to be printing something out. So the first thing I do is I actually, if you want to look at this document here, as you can see, this top and bottom borders, those are just shapes that I added to the document. So what I do is I go up here to shape, and you can just pick whatever one comes up. I like to zoom out as well a little bit. Oops, that's in. Out a little bit more so that I can see the whole document, and then I just would drag this up to the top and then drag it across, and then you can copy it and you can paste another one of the exact same size and put it on the bottom. So there you go. Then all you need to do is change the colors so that they're the right colors that are on your brand. So what I do is I go into Format over here, the paintbrush, click on the little, make sure you have the element selected that you want to change, go to the color wheel, and I have my brand color saved. So what I do is I will often go to my brand board. Let me see if I can pull one up for you really quick. Okay, so let's say I want to get this this hot pink color, and I know the hex code, but Pages doesn't let me select the hex code. So what I would do is I just click the eyedropper here, and I could come over here and select here or select right there, and it will change it. Then what I want to do to save that color is over here in Pages where I have the color, I just want to pull and drag it into my pre-selected color over here. So now that we have that color selected, we want to click on this one. We'll select that color again. I know that's different than the one over here. I hope you can follow along. I hope that's okay. We're changing things up a little bit. So we'll come back to this document. Now what we want to do is we want to select some text to add. So we want to put this title, 64 Actions to Attract More Clients Now. So if I select this here, what you can see is it's just one text box. Okay, so then what you want to do to add that text is click up here on the text icon. It'll pop a text box in here, and you just want to add the text that you desire on your title page. And then we want to make sure that we have the right font. The font I select for this is Oswald. And then let's see, what was the size here? 53, and then the 64 looks a bit bigger. It was 84. We'll put it back up to 53 first. Okay, we also want to make sure that that text is centered. And now it's starting to look the same. We're going to move it up a little bit because we have this little line that I want to add on the bottom. So first, before we add that line, let's select this text and let's make it the same color as the borders on the top and bottom. Looks good. I just want to add that line on the bottom because I think it just sort of, right now it just looks like something's missing to me. So what I'm going to do is go up here and I believe that I just did a shape and I did a line. Now there's some cool things that you can do with your lines. You can change the way it looks. So if you kind of like that paint look, you could do that. Okay, so in order to add a new page to our document, you just wanna go over here and click add page, and then you have a new page that you get to format. I'm gonna copy this text down because I just wanna start with a text box that already at least has the right font. We're gonna change the color to a different color here. Now we want to add our block of text, so we're just going to add a new text box. So normally I draft my worksheets in a Google document before I design them in Pages, and I would just copy the text over and then format it to look the way I want. And I want to make sure you understand how to add space. I don't think there's an example in this one, but let's say you wanted to create a worksheet that had space for people to type in answers. You can't actually make them editable in Pages. That's something we pay people to do on our team. It's something that's done in Adobe. But if you wanted to make space for that, let me show you that really quickly. Let's say there was a question here. What I do is I just use a shape and I just add space here. I just line it up with the text. And then I just make sure that this color is like a gray. Let's see if we can get, there we go. And I just make it a really light gray color. Let's talk about a checklist. So let's add a new page. And let's say we want to make a checklist over here. Let's say I just have my grocery list. And let's turn this into a checklist. What we're going to do over on our formatting bar over here is you're going to want to go down to bullets and lists. And you're going to want to select image here, and then you come and change the image. I think that looks pretty good. Okay, so let's say that you've finished your PDF. How do we save it and export it? What you're gonna do is go up to File, Export to PDF, and then I always select Best Quality, Next, and then I just pick a name and save my sample PDF right here. We'll throw it on my desktop. Export, and then you have it exported as a PDF. You want to make sure that you also save your document as a Pages doc so you can edit it in the future. And I would just always save it as the same name. I think that's the name I used as before, so that if you are looking for this document in the future, it's just good practice to use the same name. And we'll just go ahead and save that to my desktop. Okay, so that's how I create PDFs using Pages for Mac. It's a pretty simple process. I like it way better than other options out there, including Canva. I find Canva a little bit clunky for this process. Pages is so much better for creating worksheets and workbooks. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can go ahead and grab your copy of this worksheet right here, the final version, 64 Actions to Attract Clients Now, in the description box below this video. And then make sure that you hit subscribe to my channel, like this video if you found this tutorial helpful, and let me know down in the comments, what aspect of this tutorial was the biggest eye-opener for you? Was it, you know, how I use shapes to create these borders? Was it just how simple the process is? Let me know. I'm just really curious to know because I've been getting so many questions about creating these workbooks in Pages, and I want to know what was helpful for you. And I will see you next time.